Is your Power BI file turning into a monster? You started with a few report pages, but now you have 10, 20, or even more report pages in a single PBIX file. It's getting hard to manage, isn't it? Let me show you how to break free by cutting your Power BI in two and switching to a thin report architecture to keep all your reports organized and all your customers happy. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. Let me walk you through what I call the three-stage journey of a Power BI developer. Most folks are stuck in stage one, or maybe two, but it's stage three that unlocks everything. Stage one is where everyone starts. You're in Power BI Desktop, doing everything in a single PBIX file. You use Power Query to connect your data and load it into your model. There, you define relationships and write DAX measures. That's your semantic model. And then you build your visuals, your report pages right in the same file. But as you keep adding more and more pages to serve different audiences, sales, marketing, finance, or build more reports for the same audience, the PBIX file quickly becomes bloated. It gets harder to navigate, tougher to maintain, and more prone to breaking with every small change. Stage two is when you publish your report to PowerBI.com. Something interesting happens. Power BI separates your PBIX into two distinct objects. One is the model, also called semantic model. This is the data you loaded and the business logic implemented via relationships and DAX measures. The other is the report, your visuals. Now they appear as separate entities on PowerBI.com, but they're still somewhat tied together. You can edit the report online, but if you republish from desktop, those edits get wiped out. So while it looks like they're separate, you're not truly using that separation yet. Stage three is where the real unlock happens. You start creating new separate reports that connect to your central model. You do this on PowerBI.com by finding your semantic model and clicking Create Report. And here's the beauty of it. The model is your big file. It holds all your data and logic. It could be hundreds of megabytes or even a gigabyte or more. The reports are thin. They contain no data, just the layout, visuals, filters, etc. for the report. And every time they are displayed, they talk back to the model to get the data. This is a very good thing. Because now you have a single source of truth. You might have lived in the old Excel world of reporting with copies of report files flying around everywhere, data and formulas duplicated, errors creeping in, and nobody knowing what's right. With thin report architecture, your data lives in one place. Your logic is defined once inside a central model. Your reports are lightweight and focused and always connect to the model when displaying the data. If something needs fixing, you fix it in one place and every report using that model is instantly updated. You can scale easily. Build separate reports for separate audiences. One report for sales, one for marketing, one for finance. Or create separate reports even for the same audience based on usage scenarios. Example, one sales report to be used in sales manager's weekly meeting. Another, which the sales team uses to track their performance against goals. And another, when they're meeting with a high-value customer. Eventually, you can even keep your model in one PowerBI.com workspace and organize your reports in multiple separate workspaces to make it easy to manage security and access. Now, if you're watching this, chances are you're at stage one or two. And I just want to encourage you to dip your toe into stage three. So the next time your report pages start growing out of control, don't sweat it. Just switch to thin report architecture. Give your users focused experiences and give yourself the power to manage it all cleanly, efficiently, and at scale. If you want a step-by-step Power BI training program, which includes live Q&A calls to help you every time you get stuck and frustrated, visit learnpowerbi.com and click on training. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Power on.